everyone, I'm Dawn here from Media Club Room, and we're now live at the ASEAN China India Youth Leadership Summit 2024. And I'm now here with Mr. Michael Tan, Senior Partner and Strategy Lead at GovPlus within NCS Group, which is a gold sponsor for the summit this year. Now, Michael, in what ways does NCS view youth leadership and cross-border collaboration as essential to the future of the ASEAN China and India region?
Thanks, Dawn, and it's great to be here. I think for us, we feel cross-border collaboration is really important and working with the youth is really important. So as a business, we are not standalone. We exist within communities, and being able to align with the communities and serve the communities that we're in is extremely important. We work very closely with many governments and private businesses across the region. So I think just being able to be part of their communities and foster a lot of cross-border interactions, I think is really, really helpful.
All right. Any specific efforts or partnerships NCS has undertaken to foster these areas?
Sure. So I think participating in efforts like this conference is something that we feel is very tangible. So this is something that we do as part of the broader community efforts that we're in, where we can bring youth from, I think in this case, 12 countries, bring them together just for a week of being able to work together. So I think these are point efforts that we do. I think more broadly, we also employ staff in many different countries from many different nationalities. So being able to give them the skill sets and being able to just help them be able to interact well and pick up some of these skill sets that we think can be useful for their both professional life as well as many of these sustainability efforts, we think is very helpful.
Very nice. So what inspired NCS to sponsor the summit this year? How does this align, you know, with NCS's broader vision and goals and values?
Yeah. So we believe that we have a stated goal to advance the communities that we're in, right? And we see a lot of alignment between what OSG Alliance is doing and our stated goals as a company. So it's been a real privilege to be able to work with them. And in particular, the focus on youth is something that we feel is extremely meaningful. I think we are at a point in time where it's a place where Asia is gaining in many, many fields, right? In GDP, in population growth, but it's also gaining in areas such as emissions. And the youth are the guys that will be owning the future. So being able to work with them, being able to give them some resources and tools to help guide them and be able to combat some of these sustainability challenges, we feel is very meaningful. OSG does a great job and we're very privileged that we can be a partner.
All right, can you share a little bit more? Why this passion for youths?
For many of us, right, we think about the world we live in. And I think for the young people, it's quite amazing to see, even without preconceptions, how far they are able to push the agenda. So when I was just doing some homework and preparing for this event, I was just looking out at all the stuff that even pretty young kids, right, age 10, 12, from very small grounds up effort, they were able to inspire change. I think that's important, because I think if you are seeing change coming from peers, that inspires the young a lot more. Yeah. So I think that's why we think working with the young is really important.
So speaking about sustainability, right, the key focus for this year's summit. So how does NCS approach sustainability in its operations? And what role do you see the company playing, you know, in promoting sustainable practices among youth leaders and organizations in the ASEAN, China, India regions?
Sure. So we think of it in a couple of different dimensions. So I think the first is within our own operations, we believe it's important to live by example, right? So as a company, in how we run our activities, we invest in renewable energy, we look at our practices, we do a lot of work in technology. So we look at things about how we can green a lot of our IT practices and processes. So that's what we do in-house to lead by example. I think secondly, as a big technology company, we have a massive supply chain of companies that team up with us to serve clients. So being able to drive some of that change across the supply chain and bring our vendors on board, that's something that we are active in pursuing and educating many of our vendors as well. And the third concentric circle is beyond NCS itself, the supply chain is the broader community that we're in. And I think that's where a lot of the youths come to play. So we are the biggest technology employer in Singapore. And every year we onboard a lot of young colleagues, right? And we have also people who've been with NCS for a long time with younger kids and family. So just being able to include them in many of our activities, show them that we're leading by example is important. And some events like this, we feel, is also a way to, in a very tangible way, show the broader community that we care and we want to walk the talk.
Very nice. So when you talk about technology playing a part in sustainability efforts, right, What is some advice you can give to these youths who can actually use that, you know, to empower their sustainability efforts?
I think our encouragement for many of the youths is to be able to learn, be open to a lot of the new technologies that's out there, to experiment, to invest in it, and think about how they themselves can use it as a tool.
Alright, so coming back to the summit, right, what is something that you would hope for the youth to take away from the summit this year?
So what I hope they can take away, maybe two things, right, if I'll be greedy. So I think the first is just the opportunity for collaboration. Just stay in touch with the folks. We know that many of them were forming cross-country teams. So don't just let it be for this 1 week, but even after the week, stay in touch, continue to exchange views and perspectives around what you can do in your home country. I always believe that the future is already here. It is just not evenly distributed. So just being able to see what your peers are doing across different countries, I think is something that is meaningful and will help them. And then the second one is just don't believe that as a young person, you have no power. I think they have the longest kind of timeline, right? So feel personally empowered to take action, and even in a small way within your small community, do some action, and you never know, it can have a ripple effect that can bring much broader benefits.
Very nice. I was just talking to one of the first runner-ups last year, and she was saying that they kept in contact with their own team, and then they brought it back to the country and started a sustainability podcast, which I found was very beautiful. These kind of conferences, you know, even though it's so short, it's 1 week, but they really, you know, remember it for life. So it's very, very beautiful for me. I think last question for you personally, I've been asking from the other interviews as well, what is one piece of advice, you know, personally you would give to, you know, the future youth leaders?
Maybe travel. I think a lot of the youths now especially went through COVID, right? Which is a very unfortunate period of time where borders shut down. And I think many of them, maybe for extended period of time, have not been able to have just impersonal interactions cross-border. So now that the borders have reopened, I would really encourage them to travel, because nothing beats being on the ground and just seeing things happening, interacting with the people there. I think we are in a world right now that's a lot more contested, and just being able to have a sense of what different communities are like. And actually at the end of the day, if you get to know them well, you actually see that many people, even though they come from different parts in the world, they're all aspiring for the same things. You can find some common factors. I hope that will be something that will inspire them, and that will also be also something that will support them in their future schooling career, their work careers as well.
Very nice. So it's nothing beats being on the ground, you know, traveling and really seeing the world from your own eyes instead of through a screen.
Exactly.
Like they're very used to in COVID.
Correct. Yeah, exactly. I think things like social media, right? It's useful, but a lot of times because of algorithms and stuff, it flattens the experience, right? So being able to get beyond the screen and just get to know people for who they are, getting to know the core of what drives many people to want to do different things, I think that helps.
Thank you so much, Michael. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.
All the best for the summit. Okay.